हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसी एकेडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द जनरेशन ऑफ डीपीएसके सिग्नल। डीपीएसके इज डिफरेंशियल फेज शिफ्ट कीइंग। इट इज द डिफरेंशियली कोहेरेंट मॉड्यूलेशन मेथड, विच मीन्स इट डज नॉट नीड ए सिंक्रोनस कैरियर एट द डीमॉड्यूलेटर। इफ यू कंपेयर दिस डीपीएसके with BPSK signal, in BPSK signal we required a synchronous carrier at the receiving end to demodulate the signal, but in DPSK signal it does not need a synchronous carrier at the demodulator. It does not need synchronous carrier at the demodulator because the input sequence is modified such that the next bit depends on the previous bit. So the input sequence is modified in such a way that the next bit is depending upon the previous bit. So this is how the input sequence will be modified. Therefore, at the receiver end, the previous received bit are used to detect the present bit. So the previous received bit will be used to detect the present bit at the receiver end. That's why it does not require the synchronous carrier at the receiver end to demodulate the signal. So the first difference between BPSK signal and DPSK signal is DPSK signal does not require any synchronous carrier at the demodulator end, but BPSK signal require the synchronous carrier at the receiver end to demodulate the signal. Now let us understand how to generate or transmit the DPSK signal. This is the block diagram of DPSK generator or transmitter. Here D of t is the input sequence, B of t is the output sequence, and B of t minus TB is the previous output which is delayed by TB. So which means B of t minus TB is delayed version of B of t which is delayed by 1 bit period. Depending upon the values of D of t and B of t minus TB, the exclusive OR gate which is XOR gate generate the output sequence B of t. Now let us take an example and understand how the sequence B of t is generated. So the output sequence B of t is equal to D of t XORed with B of t minus TB. Let us take this as equation number 1. Now let us consider a sequence as an example. So depending upon D of t, we will find the sequence B of t minus TB as well as B of t, which is the output sequence. Before going to this waveform, let us write the truth table for exclusive OR gate, which is XOR gate. The input sequence is D of t and B of t minus TB, and the output sequence is B of t. Since we are having two inputs, four combinations will be there: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. For XOR gate, if input is 0, 0, output will be 0. If the input is 0, 1, output will be 1. If input is 1, 0, output will be 1. And input is 1, 1, output will be 0. Based on this table, let us see how the sequence B of t is generated. Now while drawing the waveform, initially B of t minus TB is not known, so we'll assume the value of B of t minus TB as 0 initially. I will put a star mark here, so it specifies we have assumed this value initially, because initial operation we require B of t as well as D of t to produce B of t. Now using D of t and B of t minus TB, let us find B of t. This is 0, this is 0, 0 XOR 0, B of t is 0. Since B of t minus TB is a delayed version of B of t, it is delayed by 1 bit period. So whatever output you get here, we will write here. So the same 0 we will write. So 0 we have written for the next sequence. Now 0 XOR 0, it is 0, so we will write for next sequence. 1 XOR 0, it will be 1. We'll write that for the next sequence of B of T minus TB. 0 XOR 1, it is 1. So the same one we'll write here. 0 XOR 1, it is 1. So we'll write here 1. 1 XOR 1, it is 0. We'll write this 0 here. 1 XOR 0, it is 1. So 1 we'll write here. 0 XOR 1, it is 1. We'll write here 1. 0 XOR 1, it is 1. So we'll write 1 here. 1 XOR 1, it will be 0. So we'll write 0 here. 1 XOR 0, it is 1. We'll write 1 here. 1 XOR 1, it is 0. We'll write 0. So the same 0, we'll write here 0. 1 XOR 0, it is 1. So we'll write 1 here. 0 XOR 1 is 1. From this waveform, it is clear that B of T minus TB is delayed version of B of T by 1 bit period. This is the output sequence which is produced by the input sequence D of T. So B of T is the modified version of the input sequence D of T. Based on this sequence, there will be a phase shift in the carrier signal. Now let us see the phase shift that will happen at the carrier signal depending upon the sequence B of T. Now let us understand how this phase shift will happen at the carrier. So here pi represents 180 degree phase shift at the carrier signal. Always we need to observe D of T to check the phase shift in the carrier signal. The phase shift will occur only when D of T is equal to 1, and there will be no phase shift for D of T is equal to 0. If you can observe here, we are having a bit 1 here. So there will be a phase shift of pi here. So again, there will be no phase shift for 0, 0. There will be phase shift for 1 and 1. We are having the bit 1 and 1 here. So for this, there will be a phase shift of 180 degree 2 time. For this one, we will be having a phase shift. Again, for the next one, we will be having a phase shift of 180 degree. Again, for 0, 0, we will not be having any phase shift. Again, for 1, we will be having phase shift. Again, for 0, no phase shift. So this is one of the major difference between the BPSK signal and DPSK signal. In BPSK signal, the phase of the carrier will change for both symbol 1 as well as 0, whereas in DPSK signal, phase of the carrier changes only on symbol 1, and it will not change the phase for symbol 0. For symbol 1, we are having the phase shift, and for symbol 0, we are not having any phase shift. This is very important difference between DPSK and BPSK signal. Here, if you observe, two successive bits of D of T is checked to check any change in levels in the sequence. Hence, one symbol has two bits. So we can write symbol duration T will be equal to duration of two bits, which is 2TB. So this is nothing but T is equal to 2TB. So once we obtain B of T, this B of T is given to a balance modulator. Along with that, the carrier signal is given, which will produce the signal S of T, which is DPSK signal. The carrier signal, which is given to the balance modulator, is equal to root 2P cos 2 pi f naught t. Let us take this as equation number 2. The balance modulator output will be S of T will be equal to B of T into root 2 p cos 2 pi f naught t. If we take B of T as plus or minus 1 for 0 and 1, we can write S of T is equal to प्लस आर माइनस रूट टू पी कॉस टू पाई एफ नॉट टी. The above equation gives the DPSK signal as shown in this waveform, where the phase of the carrier signal changes only when d of t is equal to 1. This is about the generation of DPSK signal. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.